Hey guys! Welcome back to Galactic Junk League!
As far as after that, I wasn't really into Transformers. I mean, I saw a couple episodes of Armada when it was on, but as far as toys went, it was mainly, that was like the tail end of my Digimon obsession, and that was like, and I had some other toys that were really cool.
And as you guys see, this is the Cyberpunk update, and well, most of you might be wondering what happened to yesterday's video.
Wait, did we not upload it?
Well, basically with the first part, my computer glitched out really, really bad.
I remember that.
The game went black. My whole screen went black, and when my screen came back on, the recording stopped.
It crashed. Everything died.
My internet was cut off.
He had to re-log into his internet, which he hasn't had to do in, like, months.
Yeah, like, I only had to, like, with my internet, like, I got a wireless adapter here, and I only need to put in the access code for it once. Like, once it's done, that's it. All I need to do is just connect to it. Something glitched to it yesterday where I had to put it in a second time. Now, that resulted...
Keep talking. I'll be right back.
Alright, dude. That resulted in two videos. And when I... Now, I went to the editor section in YouTube. Apparently, I can't put videos that are over an hour. And where these videos are completely unedited, there's nothing else I could do. So, I will get you guys caught up on what you missed. The frigate got a cannon now, which is the Gauss cannon, which I found out is essentially a sniper cannon, and it doesn't work very well, believe me. And you guys actually won't be able to see this because on the top right hand corner of my screen, right where my face is, there's actually a new profile button which you click on. Give it a second here. And it will open up a webpage, and it will give you detailed information for all your ship classes, how many games you played, what ship classes you have, and your top five most recent matches.
Is that the new Watch Mojo list?
Which, I actually like this. Gives you, like I said, it gives you detailed information on which thing. Let's see, oh, Cruiser. Cruiser only got 9 games in. Wait, Cruiser got 9 games in? What the hell?
Is it not supposed to have that?
Cruiser got 5 wins, 4 losses, okay. 17 kills. Wow. Okay, that's... Alright, the Cruiser. Ah, I was getting my Cruiser mixed up with my frigate, because my frigate is green. Did you guys see that? The bottom half of the screen. Because the Cruiser name here is in green. Don't mind me, guys. I'm an idiot. See, that actually makes sense. I couldn't think of it because I did use my cruiser a little bit. Let's see. Battleship got 10 games put in. Got 3 wins, 7 losses. That poor thing. And 16 kills. That sounds accurate. A destroyer, 3 games, 1 win, 2 losses, and no kills.
Wait, video game.
No kills.
Did I just call Battleship a video game?
And poor Frigate got nothing all around.
Battleship's a good game.
Even though I did use the Frigate in a match in yesterday's video, so I don't know why it's showing up here.
It's one of my favorite board games. Fucking Battleship. I love that game.
Oh, that's probably for today. Oh, wait, this is measured overall. I don't know. Rookie ship got 35 games, 10 wins, 25 losses, poor thing, 55 kills. Not bad. Well, it would honestly make sense for the Star Fox Mach 1 here to have more activity than with the other ships does, because that's my first ship. And I'll actually bring that into a match. And there's also different... There are 20 different profile pictures. Which you guys might actually be able to see some of them. I'm not 100% sure. But you guys will definitely be able to see them in a match. And there's even a special ability that's there when the match first starts. And I'll get into that. And I'll even show you guys the... new ships, the ship's new abilities. The frigate got a tactical swap. Swaps your position with another ship. The target can escape the swap by flying outside the escape range. Works through obstacles. That thing is pretty cool. Target range 3,000 meters. Escape range 3,200 meters. And I got a cooldown of 50 seconds and a charge of 5 seconds. Cruiser got a couple of new ones. Got Damage Leecher. Passive ability increases the damage of the cruiser based on the damage it has dealt. So, basically, the damage chain that you guys see, or as after seeing, it'll increase much faster, so basically it doubles over on itself. So the more damage I deal out, the more my damage gets increased. And the growth ratio is 20% and its max boost is 40%. So you get 40% extra damage added to your weapons, which is pretty good. Super support shield creates a protective shield around allied ships. Use this ability. Now, using this ability also buffs your permanent shield if you have it equipped. So this one is an ally support ability, which I will definitely add because I actually do have this unlocked in the Research Center. I'll actually show you guys what that looks like. Battleship got magnetic cannon, fires magnetic projectile. If the projectile hits, it puts target to your location where the sword stun. Range is 3,500 meters, cooldown 40 seconds, miss cooldown is 15 seconds. Wait a minute, is that? No. The destroyer got a couple of new abilities itself. Maneuver thrusters greatly increases horizontal and vertical strafing acceleration. So it basically makes you move up and down, left and right a lot faster. And the acceleration is 6 times normal amount. The plasma ball, which I actually have seen before, along with the magnetic cannon. This thing is pretty cool looking. You guys should be able to see that in the match as well. Fires destructive plasma ball. Everything the ball touches receives damage, and it's possible to detonate the ball for our area of effect damage. This thing is rather freaking gnarly. Cooldown is 40 seconds. The range is 4,000 meters. The damage is 5%. And the explosion size is 2,000 meters. So anyone within a 2,000 meter radius will receive 5% of their total health in damage. Yeah. Good lord. Let me actually show you this guy. Research. Let me go to research here. Oh yeah, and we also got a bomb. Charge is 8 seconds, minimum damage is 10%, max damage is 20%, and range is 1,000 meters. Self-destructure ship, damaging all nearby enemies for a percent of their HP. So up to 20% of the HP, anyone within a 1,000 meter radius gets hit. The more damage your ship is... The more damaged your ship is, the more damage the explosion deals. So up to 20% of your ship being damaged, when that bomb goes off, your enemy's receiving that 20%. Or say 20% or more.
Or it's free.
And here's the super support shield. I like how the bang is like a little miniature nuke. Here's what the super support shield looks like. I'm definitely adding that. Here's the plasma ball. That thing looks pretty cool. Yeah, I've seen this thing before. This thing's actually pretty freaking big. Now, I'm not sure what the next thing I'm going to go for. Like, I could go for the Graviton Beam, the Super Support Shield for the Cruiser. I could go for the Artillery Mode, the Plasma Ball for the Destroyer. I could go for the Bang. Or I could save up, try going for the Advanced Gyroscope, the Mega Armor, or the Heavy Laser. Now, the thing is, I could go for abilities and like support my ship a bit more and even possibly help out ally ships. Yeah, someone actually used a super support shield on me once before. It's actually quite cool. Or I could basically help out myself or help out supporting or help out my teammates. I'm going for this. Give me my super support shield. That thing is going to come in handy. That's for my cruiser. And AP-140X. Excellent. So let's take this off. Let me open up. Let me put this. That thing got an awesome animation. Wait a minute. Okay, so that's just... Oh, that looks cool, actually. It looks really cool. Okay. I'm certainly going to want to have one of these. Ability limit reach, yep. Gonna figure that. It almost looks like a little antenna tower. That looks cool. See, I could put it here and have it look like a little antenna, but the thing is, that'll get shot off really freaking easily.
I'm imagining you like this, the person you had an antenna that you blown the fuck off.
Yep. I'm gonna put this here.
Really?
And I'm putting my permanent shield right there. I'm sorry, guys. That animation is just too freaking cool. Just look at it. Best up my camera angle. Here we go. Just slow. I'm just slow. Close up around the ball. That's pretty cool. Cruise missile. I might actually put some of this aesthetic stuff on, like, once I get the ships, like, fully. But give me my armor plates. So I'm not gonna lie, I do like the look of the, like, the aesthetic stuff. Oh yeah, I even added some hull blocks here just so I can fill out a little bit more, because when this thing levels up, I am not going to add any more weapons. This thing is definitely going to be getting some more armor. Now, our question is, what ships are actually bringing to the match? Oh yeah, I said I was going to bring in the Star Fox Mach 1. There we go. Oh yeah, and I'll explain this little lake system. So you guys probably noticed, like, little green lake symbols on the bottom, or say, yeah, on the bottom of the ships here, next to the logos. And ones that got the most likes is the Star Fox Mach 1 and the frigate. Nah, didn't have nostrils offline. Yesterday's video.
Are you gonna troll him again?
Yesterday's video was so much fun. Like, At one point, we just finished doing a match, and I noticed that Nostra was actually on, so I literally waited for him to be done with his match so that we could get into a match together. It was freaking hilarious. He was on the opposite team, though, and my framemate was crapping, and I got freaking annihilated. And it was ever so much of a pain in the ass. Now, what ships I'm going to be bringing in for this video other than the Star Fox Mach 1, I don't know. Oh yeah, something else I mentioned in yesterday's video too. Keep an eye on this back section, the section here with the two rocket launchers onto it. I got extremely big plans for that. I mean, I like this ship how it's like small, well armored, and rather like tightly compact. Like, this honestly looks really cool. Like, there's an octagon front section here, and then you got a almost like a diamond shape here. Oh yeah, and the funny thing is, during not yesterday's match, but a match 2 days ago I had off camera, the whole entire front section here with the four missile launchers on it was sliced clean off. Like, all the blocks here, like with the slopes just behind it, they were all intact. Along with the hull blocks in the middle. It's just the front end. It was just sliced clean off. It was freaking hilarious. Oh my god. Because, I mean, a clean cut is not something that usually happens with a match. Like, usually if something is blown off, it's going to be erratic and it's going to be random. It's not just like laser precision. It's weird. Okay, we're in a 7v7 match. But yeah, this like system here, for every ship that you like, you actually give them. It looks kind of cool. Oh yeah, I'll show you guys the new skin pack. Yeah, you actually got... Yes, I got a like. Thanks, guys. Yeah, you actually, Hey, I remember you. Shoehart. I remember you from yesterday's match. This guy got a pretty cool, build. He got pretty much got a Rubik's Cube going on. Yeah, for every ship that you like, either be on your team or on the enemy's team, you can give them, or you give them an extra 20% of junk and XP, which I actually quite like. Is that way, friend or foe, everybody benefits. It's pretty cool. Alright, the game is saying, you like this build? These guys put a lot of hard work into it, so we'll give them a reward. There it is again! Oh, I read... Oh yeah. There's the little ability there. You, for each match and each time you respawn, you get a temporary engine boost. And I'm certain that message goes out is either Latin or German. I don't know, because I actually read it. Off the, I basically post recording, like I literally. That's the phone ringing, guys. Don't mind that. I literally looked at the, I literally watched the video, and I paused for the message. Yeah. And at the time I joined the video, like that message literally shows up and disappears really quick, so you don't get a chance to read it. And yesterday was the first time I ever seen it. And so, and when I read it, yesterday, I paused the video, I'm just like, what the hell does this say? And, like, I still don't know what it says. Hi, Sebby. Why I like rockets. Hi, Sebby. Name Sim, you freaking jerk. Yeah, I'm definitely going to be putting a generator on this. Because this thing... got the generator overload. What the hell? That's first. They freaking shot out my engine overdrive. I love homing missiles. They might be considered cheap or lazy to some people, but they're freaking awesome. It's like, for yesterday's video, I was thinking, like, the generator, because I'm not quite, thanks, Dober Dog. Oh, yeah, that's one of the new animations there when you die. There's even, like, that little same, Skull and Crossbones shows up, when you kill somebody, too. What was I saying? But yeah,
I'm gonna do that all the time.
Missiles and basically homing rockets may seem like cheaper, lazy for most players, but I personally love them. Why? You can absolutely completely bombard your enemies. And in a game like this, where you need to keep a constant eye on with a 360 degree area all the way around you, you best make sure you got good enough weapons to help cover for that. Because if you don't, you're gonna be dead. Double dog, give me. Whoa. Slow down, Star Fox. Slow down. And I still got all my weapons. Oh, yeah. No way, Double Dog. I'm not sure if that's the tactical jump or not, but that thing looks cool. I think it is, though. Oh, what? I didn't get that. That was crap. Come on, Sebi.
People.
Come on, Sebi. You shot out both of my overdrives, my engine and generator. Crap. Oh yeah, and something really weird happened with oh wait, that's the last video that's already been put up with the dead match. And apparently you guys really liked that video. Thanks for liking it and commenting, by the way. As I said in previous episodes, all you guys' support is greatly appreciated.
We are raw support.
Extremely grateful. Yes.
Yes.
There's one of the...
Hello.
At a dead Baba. Good lord, man. Yeah, that's one of the new icons. What the hell is going on?
Doing my Wasp narrative voice again because I'll never get tired of it.
Whoa, okay, something here is going on in the chat. I don't even want to know.
I'm having a big, like, cyber orgy.
You're close. I'm just saying. It's just basically just like, just basically just general.
Oh jeez, who are you talking to here?
Chat. Just general BJ stuff going on. Good lord. Things people mention. Good lordy hell. And no, we're not spawned by Kinder. I just really love these buenos.
What about buenos? What's a bueno? Spanish for good?
You haven't seen a Kinder Bueno before?
I know about the Kinder eggs. I don't know what a bueno is. I know that's Spanish for good, and I've seen the Kinder eggs, but...
You're amazing. Look them up. Look them up later.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Kinder makes good chocolate, so I'm just, you know. Wait, is Kinder like a Spanish company? I mean, buenos, that's a Spanish one. Is this like a Canadian? We don't get Kinder shit here, because kids here eat the toys and die.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Because American kids are stupid. Cause yeah, okay. But that fucking Burger King Pokemon shit, like, that still kills me. Like how fucking... So, they have these little plastic Pokeballs that have like little toys in them, right?
Shoe heart.
Oh, I still have one in the toy room here, right?
You betrayed me. You got a like anyway.
Whoa. And you open the ball and it has a little toy inside. It has like, you know, there's had like a Butterfree plushie. There was like a little... There was a little light up Charmander, which I still have. Like there was stuff like that. Oh, little Magnemite top, which there's one of those around here somewhere.
Just a magnetic launcher.
but they had little toys. And what kids would do, some kid did this. They took the top of it and put it completely over his nose and mouth and sucked it in and almost suffocated to death and got brain damage from it. And they had to ban those fucking things because a kid did that.
Oh my god, that's so cool. Pig Gamer Ah, he got a build that's modeled after freaking King Kong holding on to the top of an antenna on the skyscraper. That's so cool.
King Gamera?
Pig Gamer Ah. He got freaking King Kong holding onto the top of a skyscraper for a build. That's so cool.
His name might be Gamera, because that's also a giant monster, a giant monster movie. And that would make sense that someone with that name would have a King Kong thing.
That's so cool. That's
kaiju.
Would you consider King Kong a kaiju?
I mean, he's a giant monster.
And
he did fight Godzilla a couple times. I consider him a kaiju.
Well, then again, he's just a giant primate, but King Kong kaiju, I can definitely see.
I mean, okay, he's just a giant primate. What is Godzilla? A giant fucking lizard.
Good point.
What's Mothra? A giant butterfly. What's Gamera? A giant turtle.
I can keep going. That's so cool.
I can keep going.
Backup battery kick in.
Because a lot of your movie monsters and your Godzilla monsters are giant blank.
I'm gonna wait.
That's it. They're giant.
Frickin' Shoehart.
Or robot blank.
Hey.
Or Zhezhaga. I fucking love Zhezhaga. Zhezhaga.
Slow down, you hyperactive crazy.
Who, me?
No, my ship, the freaking overdrive is making this thing go way too fast.
Look up the Mystery Science Theater 3000 version of the Jet Jaguar song from Godzilla. It's amazing. Thank you, Matt, because goddamn that he does he. Because Matt and two best friends play is really into Godzilla, and I've found a lot of the stuff out through him. Because he did a whole week of Godzilla once. Because Godzilla is fucking awesome.
That build is just way too awesome. I'm just sitting here just pretty much gobsmacked by it now. This thing's so cool.
Godzilla and all the kaiju stuff is cool, but also there's so much stupid shit there that's fun to laugh at. Have you ever seen that gif of Godzilla doing a kick where he's just sliding with his tail into the other monster? Or the other one, where he's fucking in the air, propelling himself backwards with his fire breath. It's amazing.
I'm certain I've seen that one.
That is the goofiest shit I've ever seen. I love it.
Did his tail happen to turn into different rainbow colors?
I think this was in black and white, but it might have been in rainbow colors. I don't know.
Because I do remember one a lot like that, and the scales on the top of his tail basically changed different rainbow colors as he basically fired his laser.
That's a different one, then. I'm thinking of the old one where he's using some kind of weird breath thing to basically... It's like if you took a balloon and let the air out of it and let it fly slowly. It was like that. It looks really dumb. I'll have to send you that later.
Yeah, let's see if I've seen it before, because I do recall one that's a lot like that.
Here, I'll fucking Google it and I'll send it to you when we're done recording. But yeah, there's a lot of really in a lot of that fucking tokusatsu shit in general, that's just the all-encompassing for... That's the all-encompassing term for anything that has actors in suits playing as giant characters. So that's all your Sentai shit, all your Godzilla, all that stuff. It's kind of, you know, if you think about it, like Power Rangers and like Super Sentai and all that shit's kind of in the same family. Kamen Rider, like, it's all in Godzilla, they're all in the same family of dudes in monster suits.
Take that, Pig Gamera.
So, you
Shoe
know,
Heart, you're gonna die. There. Frickin' jerk. Cylon! You're mine. Okay, crap. I need to research. Whoa! What happened to me? Thanks, Pete Gamera, Tig Devitt. Enjoy. That guy is having real fun. I just looked it up.
Every goddamn time.
I was just gonna say, you looked it up, didn't you?
Dude, it cracks me up every fucking time.
Here we go. There's more icons. I'm the guy, and I got the same icon as Shoeheart here. My favorite color is blue. Okay. Have you guys taken notice of that yet?
Also, if you want more Godzilla, just play a Metroid game. All the monsters' roars are taken from Godzilla movies. Like, a lot of them are. Really, a lot of games in general and a lot of movies in general just take sound clips from different Godzilla roars and repurpose them for their own monsters, but... Like, Craig specifically is one I've heard somewhere before, but I forget who it was.
Okay. Craig
from Zero specifically. But yeah, like, all the bosses in Super Metroid, all their roars are taken from different Godzilla monsters.
Okay, now there's people here talking about ass whooping. So what's his name here is literally named Cheetos. C-H-E-A-T-O-S, Cheetos.
Or when you say that, I imagine Chester Cheetah in bondage gear. I don't know if I want this image in my head.
And it says here, and with a name like that, expect an ass whooping.
Again, now I believe. Now I just got the image of Chester Cheetah in bondage gear. Fuck you, Art. And now someone's going to draw that. One of our viewers is going to be an artist, and they're going to draw that, and that's going to exist because of us. And Mr. Cheeto over here.
Dude, are you, with this being the internet, are you sure that those sort of things don't already exist?
Probably, actually. You know what? I almost guarantee that someone has drawn something like that. I love living in this age.
There we go. Match found. See who we're up against.
I'm just gonna put this in there. You might get a thingamajiggy, but you can look at it when we're done.
Alright. What the hell? Oh my god, it's a hand with a pointing finger. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, this is the GIF I'm talking. Well, GIF, video, whatever. No, I don't want to use an emoji. I'm good.
Oh my god, it's a pointing finger. I just took notice of it. It's a finger literally pointing. That's pretty cool. Yeah, you got a leg for me, dude. That's cool.
Whoa. I hear
ya. Thanks for the like. You know that thing's not fully armored.
Boy, I fucking love our potato wedges.
Yeah. How about How about loaded potato wedges?
Please tell me you had some when you were at KFC today, because, dude, their potato wedges are awesome.
Actually, no, but I actually had loaded potato wedges where? I had some loaded potato wedges somewhere, but I forget where. And, oh, do at my local Tim Hortons. Any Canadian would know that place.
Yep, I hear Canadians talk about Tim Hortons all the time.
And, oh, just my support shield, the little barter for it. Basically, they're potato wedges with chili and cheese.
That sounds amazing.
It is. Hang on, Pete Gamera. I'm gonna help you out, dude. Boink.
Alright. If I ever come up there, you and me, we're going to Tim Hortons. We're gonna have some Canadian shit. We're gonna have all the Canadian delicacies. No, man, but KFC potato wedges, man, I could fucking inhale those, dude. Those are so good. Really, all KFC's side shit's really good. I like a lot of KFC's side dish is better than their actual chicken.
How much damage did I receive? Doesn't look like much.
Seriously, I've always liked their sides better than their extra chicken, but their extra chicken's not bad. But.
Oh, good, I got my shield back. Sweet. And my... Oh, my main shield is... Wait, is that my main shield? Is that my... No, that is my main shield. So they got an update where it actually shows you your shield now. And I'm hacked.
That's useful.
Yeah, it shows under my energy bar for my weapons. It's pretty cool. Command James Tiberius Kirk. Anyone who knows that name will know a classic show called Star Trek.
Come on, everyone knows Star Trek.
Yep.
I've never watched it.
If you like sci-fi shows, you'd like that.
I know I'd like it, I just never got around to watching it. My dad watched it and he had a bunch of Star Trek books.
That's like my dad, like he's the Star Trek guy.
I think everyone's dad loves Star Trek. I think this is like a dad show.
Yeah, I even like the show myself. I mean, I'm after seeing several episodes of several different series of it when I was younger. Just a good show in general. Thanks, Camille Palak.
Speaking of Star Trek, that sounds like it's Klingon or something.
Oh shit. Whoa, frame rate. Oh god. I am really.
I've never seen Star Trek. I've never seen any of the series. I've never seen any of the movies.
Apparently, Klingon is a legit language you can
learn. Oh, yeah, I've heard about that forever. I mean, are there Zelda people out there that can... There's Zelda fans that can write Hylian. Like...
That's pretty cool.
If there's made-up languages, people have tried to learn it and make it a real one. Not the easiest made-up language ever, though, is. The unknown from Pokemon. Those are just letters.
Yeah. Thanks, Kinetique,
Hey.
You know, Bionicle has their own language as well, but their own written language that I used to know really well, but I forgot most of it.
Hmm.
But there is a written language for that.
Okay, I'm going to sound like an absolute nerd here, so guys, be ready for it.
Alright.
Of all the made-up languages that I know, this one language I actually like to be able to learn, if possible.
What?
Cybertronian.
Yeah.
No, like, one made-up language... And Bionicle, it's mainly a written language in Bionicle. They all talk in English, but, the people who live in, like, the grass areas, or, like, the jungles and stuff, have, like, a weird way of talking. Where they say shit backwards. It's kind of like a Pig Latin type thing.
Huh.
And it's kind of weird. I used to troll the fuck out of my brother with it, too.
There's a destroyer. I'll bring that in for a match. Wait a minute. Is there anything here that's...
Seriously, like, I got when I got on the Bionicle Wiki recently, I was like, wow, there's a lot of cool stuff. A lot of stuff I forgot, too.
Wait a minute.
Okay, okay.
Let's bring this in for one last match.
A series based on a kid's Lego toy has a straight-up Lovecraftian horror homage.
Wow.
His name's Trem Crom, and, like, he is the only completely organic creature in Bionicle. And he's basically a red blob with constantly regrowing tentacles and eyes. What does that sound like? That's some Lovecraft shit right there.
Yep.
And hell, certain characters, like they say, if you look at them, he'll drive you insane. And that's Lovecraft as fuck.
Yep.
And hey, it was more tongue-in-cheek than the fucking Ben 10 was. Yeah, let's just have Dagon be the final fucking boss of the series.
Wow.
Which is wrong, because it was actually Cthulhu specifically they were fighting, but they called him Dagon. And I'm like, okay, if you're going to go all in with your Cthulhu references, go all in and just call it Cthulhu. Then again, Digimon did the same thing, Egomon. And there was a straight-up episode, there was an entire episode of Digimon Season 2 that was an homage to Shadow over Innsmouth. I shit you not.
Wow. And did you know there's, in Scubanauts Unlimited, there's legitimately...
I know, you can get a Shoggoth in a Cthulhu, I know.
Yeah, you can literally spawn him into the game. Now, I'm not sure if you can spawn him in... the other games, like the original game and Unmasked, or two, I...
Unmasked, I'm sure there's a DC equivalent you can summon. I'm sure, like, Constantine or Dr. Fate or someone's fought some Cthulhu shit.
Because, like, the great thing about Unmasked is, like, you still get the regular Scribonauts items.
But DC stuff.
And you get DC stuff thrown in as well.
Now that was another... There was like a bunch of Cthulhu references in Season 2 and 3 of Digimon, like in 3. Like the main... Like the main computer they create basically to kill the Digimon is called Yugoth, and that's a Lovecraft reference. Hypnos is the name of the company. That company that runs it, that's another Lovecraft reference.
Mm-hmm.
The D-Reaper... looks Lovecraftian as shit. Like, yeah, like, I think it was one of the writers was really into it, so he just kind of sprinkled references everywhere. But yeah, it's pretty cool.
I'm not repeating that, that's just...
Then again, we talked about the same series bit in Season 4, just straight up had Lucifer.
TIE Fighter, Instant Like. No, that is...
I need to see the new movies. I haven't seen any of the new movies.
That is Darth Vader Starfighter, to be exact.
I need to see the new movies. I haven't seen Force Awakens or Rogue One. I need to watch those at some point.
What the frickin' hell? Oh my god, this is a wall of weapons. That looks pretty cool.
I've seen all six movies, but I barely remember the prequels.
Oh, that must be, yeah, that's Mark Target. I don't think I have that one yet. But I do have artillery mode. I do have that.
Mark, I just think of with a Mal, as in Deadpool.
Uh-huh.
Deadpool's awesome. That's another movie I want to see. I haven't seen the Deadpool movie.
Alright, last match. Let's see what we can do here.
They better put him in Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. I mean, come on. He was in 3. That was before he blew up.
Legion 80. I thought that said something about lesbian. Ah, my freaking eyes. Whoa!
Are you getting dyslexic on me?
Yeah, I just looked at the name way too fast. They got him out of range. Turn right, turn right, turn right, turn right. I'm pressing A. It's pressing A instead of D. Dang it. Here we go. There we go, there we go, there we go, there we go, there we go. Dr. Jerkberg. Nice. That is a peculiar noise.
What?
You guys hear that? It's coming from this game. It's a really weird noise. Someone must be using a, item. Mind, Dr. Jerkberg. I'm going down. Ah, crap. Come on, come on, come on. Kill him! Oh god. I need to wait for my... I'll wait for my weapons. Whoa! Okay. This side looks relatively fine. This side... Yeah. It's not really much you can say about that. What the hell? You freaking jerk. What the hell? Freaking Legend 80. Ass. You really need to get used to these new freaking engine boost. Because that... Now, for anyone that has used the ability before, that doubles your speed.
That was good.
And for some of these ships...
Like the kitchen, I was eating dinner as I was...
Yeah, I'm not quite used to that speed increase.
Hence why I started talking about chicken tenders. I mean, not chicken tenders, that fucking, potato wedges. Potato wedges are fucking good.
Why the? I'm not getting any kill assists. What the hell? Whoa, okay, there goes my bottom missile launcher.
And like, I can inhale french fries, but no. Potato wedges are better than french fries. I'm gonna say it. And I love french fries to death, but goddamn, potato wedges are better.
And there goes my both of my overdrive abilities.
Because they're bigger, they have more potato and more flavor. They're like the mega evolution of a french fry.
Oh shit, that's a bomb, that's a bomb, that's a bomb, that's a bomb.
Is this going to be my theme food? Like, fucking Optimus Prime's always talking about fucking pizza bagels, Megatron's talking about burritos, I'm talking about fucking potato wedges.
Thanks, Cryo Wolf.
Whatever, I'll take it.
Nah.
Like potato wedges. Fucking good.
And what would mine be? The stereotypical Canadian poutine?
R.
I can't really complain all that much.
R. Yours is the same as your favorite video game characters.
Yeah, true.
You fucking love chili dogs.
Actually, yes I do, and I, first one I had it was about 3 years ago during during the regatta. Oh my god, I loved it. It's a, for anyone who doesn't know what the regatta is, it's a big event that happens during the summer where a bunch of people gather around and there's a bunch of stalls put up where people sell things. And boat races.
Ooh.
And people say that we do nothing but live in igloos. I mean, really? We have cool stuff up here, too.
In Newfoundland, we expect you to have boats, because that's what Newfoundland is known. It's like a port town, ain't it?
Pretty much.
That's what I do know about Newfoundland, is like they're like a port town, and their element is water.
Like there's literally like a wharf, just like about like a 20-minute walk away from my house. Stop moving. Whoa.
I mean, though, we're going to talk because, like, there's rivers surrounding this state. There's rivers everywhere. And Louisville, where I used to live, is known as the River City, so, you know.
Here we go. See if I managed to unlock anything. Four games of missile type weapons. Come on!
Pretty much everywhere lived has been within close vicinity of a river.
Okay, so I haven't been able to get anything. Okay.
They're all over the place.
Alright, so guys, that's gonna have to do it for this time. Ooh, I got another eye.
The words of Geddy Lee.
A river!
That's from Tom Sawyer.
Oh yeah, I remember that. So guys, fire your missiles at the like button if you guys enjoyed, and we'll see you in the next one. Later, guys.
Bye-bye. Give me more potato wedges.
Couldn't you guys tell that we like food?